Hello everyone, welcome back to the Rise of Empires guides. So finally we have some good news in Rise of Empires. We have some of the major updates we had in this game, I believe, related to Eden. This next Eden that will start tomorrow will have new rules, guys. The new rules are only two factions will exist in this new Eden, the North and the South factions. After your alliance registers, they will place into one of these factions based on the matchmaking rules just as before, but instead of many factions that you can choose and, you know, combine together, basically there will be only two factions, two guilds. All the other things here are already we know about. You contribute to your faction, you know, you get your occupation value up, you know, it's all the same things, just as the previous Edens. What we have new here is the strongholds. Once a guild captures it, all commanders of the same faction can then utilize the stronghold to connect territories. Strongholds provide commanders of the same faction better ways to strategize and adjust their troop movements. This is basically the same thing as the Guardian base that we had in the previous, you know, original Reign of Chaos that you can use on defense and offense. I don't know if this one will be movable. I think this one will be stationary building in the map, but nonetheless it's a good tool for the leaders to use the members' troops, you know, it's a good way. Next we see the guild development. Basically you will again start with 100 players, and as you go through you will be able to get up to 200 players per faction. This is kind of a problem for me, not a problem, but you know, disappointment more or less. When they said two factions, let's go back here, two factions, one versus one, I expected like at least 300 players per faction, or maybe up to 400 players, you know, because it's only one versus one. If it's the same size map as the previous Edens, and if it's only 200 players versus 200 players, I mean, it doesn't really make sense. What are we going to do at the first 2 weeks of the 2 weeks of the event? You know, there won't be any human interaction. You will be only taking tiles until you meet at the middle, basically, right? Everyone will be taking the cities, the gates, maybe, you know, the other buildings, you know, they will be tiling. But it will be kind of boring, and I thought developers intended to make it more action-packed. But this part will make the early game kind of boring, I believe. But maybe they have something in mind. Maybe they like made a smaller map for this one. I don't really know. We are going to see about that one. I hope there's something to it. If it's just like the regular map, it's going to be kind of boring. With Eden on our doorstep, if you are going to spend any money in this game, it better be in AppGallery, guys. With their newest campaign, you can get back 50% cashback in your first purchase and 20% cashback on your remaining purchases made in Rise of Empires until 30th of June. Plus, you can get 4 coupons if you spend over certain amount. Also, anyone that downloads the game from AppGallery will have this amazing welcome gift package worth of 10 euros. And if you spend over 1000 euro per month, you can join the VIP club to get 15% cashback. Regardless of any ongoing campaign, VIP users will always have 15% cashback. So if you spend over 1000 euro per month, please contact me from Discord for the VIP link. Just one thing, because there are still some questions about it, a combination of payment using Huawei points together with the bank card is not eligible to enter the campaign. But you can join this campaign from anywhere in the world and with any Android device or using your PC with an emulator program. Also, you do not need to delete your game that you have on your phone right now if you wish to keep it. AppGallery has a Discord group that you can join to keep updated with the promotions. From time to time, there are Huawei point giveaways in the Discord group. One Huawei point is equal to 1 euro, so don't miss out. Download the AppGallery from the link below. Don't forget to bind your account to IM30 or Facebook before you switch to AppGallery. Set your country to Italy, Netherlands, or Greece. Go to the promotion and click Rise of Empires. After that, you can launch the game and buy any package. Before the purchase, we have 0.46 euros worth of Huawei points. This package should give us 1.5 Huawei points after our purchase. Continue and accept the terms and conditions of the campaign. And now you are ready to claim your rewards. Anyway, let's check the rewards. Rewards are based on winner and defeat factions, as well as ranking within the faction. Once the season ends, the faction with the highest control point wins. If the both faction has the same value, they both counted as defeated. This part I really like it. Good job, man. Why I like this one? Because you don't really have a chance to make any deals. You cannot really lose in a graceful way, or you cannot tie to get like mediocre rewards. You basically need to win if you want the good rewards. And if you're going to lose, it's just the same thing anyway. You better fight instead of giving them to win. I like this decision. I think it will create a pretty action-packed event. So it will be like more active than the previous Edens. We're going to see, I guess. And other than that, what is new is there are ranks now. I think these ranks will be same as the Clash of Province ranks. So depending on your performance on the battlefield or tiling, etc., you will get these ranks. And it will take away from the leaders to make decisions which rewards will be given to who. Instead of that, you will basically get your rewards based on your rank. For example, if you're a member and if you're rank 1, you will get 2 of these tickets. And for example, if you're rank 4, you will get 1 of these tickets, 1 per each of the tickets. And let's say if you're rank 10, you will get only 1 ticket in this type. I mean, it's kind of better for the leaders. You know, leaders always have problem giving these rewards. There are always some players that get upset, and rightfully so. You know, you really work hard, no matter what other players do. You yourself worked out, and sometimes you don't get the rewards that you think you deserved, and it's kind of a problem. This one will basically eliminate that. You're going to get the rewards that game thinks you deserved. You know, you or your leader do not really have a say into this. You basically need to work hard. And the rewards are the same. You know, you have regular legendary selection cards, S1 to 4 legendary selection cards, and designated legendary hero recruitment ticket. This one is basically hero recruitment. So you are going to be choosing any of these heroes listed here. These are Last Shelter survival heroes. For Rise of Empires, we're going to have Rise of Empires heroes. So at the end, what I think about this one, I think it will be action-packed, it will be exciting, and it will be less of a political gameplay and more of a battle-based gameplay. I hope this works. I'm, as I said, curious about the first 2 weeks of the event until we get to the middle of the map. What's going to happen in this, like when you're on the way to the map, it could be kind of boring. I don't know what we're going to do, but I mean, it's exciting news at least. I'm really happy. Even if it doesn't work out, I'm really happy that these developers are trying to bring something new to the game, so the older states, like older players like myself, are not really bored for this game, you know, bored of this game. Anyway, tomorrow will be first day of the Eden. I will try to record my first day of the Eden. I hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to leave a like and comment down below what do you think about this new Eden. Have a good day, y'all. Bye-bye.